Well, what do you reckon, Frankie? Will we give it a go?
Yeah. Whoever lives here is either lazy or can't get about too good. Let's give it a burl.
Sister Marie, and this is Sister Frieda. We've been sent from our convent to call on those people who, well, are in need of a bit of a chat and some company.
Do you realise you're the first visitors I've had in about 2 months?
You, don't have a family?
Well, yes, but I'm lucky to see them once a year.
But surely the neighbours pop in now and then.
People don't want to seem to spend the time these days. Once you're old, you're forgotten. Oh, but I'm so rude. Please, do come in, sisters. I'll make a cup of tea.
Sit down, sisters.
Oh, no, let me make it. You just tell me where everything is.
Well, if you insist, the kitchen's through there, sister. It's all on the bench, the caddy-marked tea.
You just take it easy.
Yeah, sit down. It's all part of the service.
Do you do this sort of work all the time?
Oh, yeah, it's part of the vows we took. It's a full-time job looking after those people who are in need of comfort and help.
Oh, you must be very busy.
Yeah, keeps you on the go.
Must be very hard for you keeping this place going and getting to the shops.
And the bank?
Oh, I manage. I don't need much. And what's in the bank stays there. You see, I'll keep a little money hidden here in the house for anything unexpected that might pop up.
Well, that's handy.
Yes. I don't think I'm taking any chances, really. It's not much. Just saves a trip. Oh, and I don't like banks anyway. They always make you feel you're taking someone else's money.
Here we are. Sister. Milk and sugar?
Oh! What have you found this time, Lizzie?
Benny, look at that!
Well, so what? It's a medical book, isn't it?
What is it?
You keep away, Karen!
Oh, what's the old cow fussed about now?
She's found us of a man, girls. She's been here so long she's forgotten what they look like.
That's not funny. It shouldn't be in this book. It's got nothing to do with disease.
Oh, I know some girls that tell you different.
Should be torn out.
I'll stick him on my wall any time you like.
Listen, while we're on the subject.
Huh?
Well, Marilyn and Eddie.
I told you I wasn't interested.
I just want you to think about it.
I don't have to think about it. I am not turning over my shop to some kid electrician who's got the sack and who's tied up with a con.
Marilyn's a good kid.
I know. It's nothing against her personally. It's just the principle of the thing.
What bloody principle?
Never trust a con or their boyfriend.
Well, whose side are you on? You're a con.
It's beside the point.
That is exactly the point.
Get your hands off me, B. Smith, or I'll flatten you.
Smith! Oh, just admiring the cut of Ferguson's dress, Vera. Suits her. Baggy. Get back to your work. Travers, outside.
You creep.
Yeah. I just want to warn you to watch your step, Travers. I'll be keeping my eye on you even more now that I know what game you're playing.
What are you talking about?
You and your Dr. Miller. The governor may see fit to forget the whole thing, but as far as I'm concerned, it doesn't rest there.
Of course not.
You think you're pretty clever, but I know your sort, Travers. Carry on like you're quite the little lady, but I know what you're up to. I know the way you operate, using your body to get what you want. Not much better than a whore, really. You'd do anything for a soft ride in this place. Even let an animal like Frankie Doyle have her way with you. I'm surprised she didn't take you with her. Yes, Travers.
Oh, when I was your age, I worked as a milliner's assistant for old Mrs. Branscombe. She was very strict, but she was fair.
What's a milliner, Miss McBride?
We made lovely hats. Everyone wore hats in those days. Now it's all blue jeans and leather things, isn't it?
Some.
Why didn't you ever get married?
Oh, that's a long story. There was a man, but you wouldn't want to hear about that, sister.
Oh, yes, I would. Wouldn't we?
Yeah. He was killed in the war.
Fighting the Japs?
Oh, no, dear. The First War. I'll just take these things out into the kitchen.
Frankie!
Right, we bash the old girl straight off, grab the money she's got stashed away and clear out now.
No!
That was the whole idea. You keep stopping me.
We don't even know where the money is.
We'll find it.
Just wait.
I'm sick of sitting around. It's not getting us anywhere.
I don't want you to hurt her.
What's the matter with you, Doreen?
Just don't touch her, that's all.
I've been watching you. I think you've been in these bloody clothes too long. You're getting soft in the head.
Please, Frankie.
Well, I've had a wonderful afternoon. It's been such a joy having the two of you here. This old house is so empty all the time. It's just been lovely.
We've had a good time too, Miss McBride.
If only you could stay longer, but I know you have to be getting back.
Yes.
You know, I had the silliest idea out in the kitchen. I thought, wouldn't it be nice if the two of you could... Oh, I'm being silly.
What?
I thought, wouldn't it be nice if you could stay here for a little while with me?
Us stay here?
Yes. I know I'm a silly old woman. It's just not done, is it?
Oh, I reckon we could do it. Oh, only this once. And not for long, though. It's been done before in the line of duty, hasn't it, sister?
Yeah. Oh, that's wonderful. And I promise you, you won't have to worry about a thing.
You asleep, Marilyn?
Are you kidding?
Look, kid, I'm sorry I couldn't swing it for you and Eddie.
It's not your fault. You did your best. I can hardly blame her, really. She doesn't know me or Eddie.
But I know. That should be good enough.
Sure would have been something to look forward to, running our own little milk bar down by the beach. Eddie's been so down lately, not being able to find a job. What are you doing?
Bringing someone to their senses. I'm going to do this to you every night in here. You understand? Every bloody night until you speak to Marilyn's Eddie. And if you don't like him, you can keep your damn shop. But just talk to him once. That's all I ask. And I'll even stop complaining about your god-awful snoring. All right? Is it a deal? Oh, see you. Oh, Jesus. Oh.
Get in the bag.
You sure made one heck of a promise.
Yeah.
Mrs. Brooks? Miss Vernon? Has the governor spoken to you yet?
Yes. She told me my parole had been agreed to, thanks to you.
Did she also tell you that I'd be your probation officer?
Yes, that too. I never would have believed anyone could be so lucky, Miss Vernon, to be given another chance like this. I'm so grateful to you.
Well, Meg Jackson and the governor had something to do with it.
Oh, yes, I know. I shan't forget that.
Well, I'd also like to tell you that I found you a two-bedroom flat for you and your granddaughter. Oh. A very small flat, nothing palatial. And I spoke to your daughter and son-in-law about everything. And I think they'll come round, given time.
I hope so.
Your son-in-law even offered to lend a hand financially. So the signs are there.
What can I say except thank you?
Oh, well, the only thanks that we need, Mum, is for you to make sure that it works.
Don't you worry about that. Oh, Miss Vernon, you've been so helpful to me, I wondered if there was anything you could do for Lynn Warner.
Oh, well, I can't do anything until after a trial. But you never know. I'll see.
And how are you today, Mrs. Travers?
Fine, thanks.
Good. Now, I've had a word with your neighbors, and one of them says that she did overhear you and your husband quarreling quite often. And she also says that she saw your husband coming home drunk a couple of times. Fall down drunk. Is that true?
Yes.
Well, you said he drank. I didn't realize.
Yes, all right. It's true. He got very drunk.
Mrs. Travers, I know this is upsetting. You make that perfectly clear. I am working for you.
I'm sorry.
Now, what was the name of your doctor?
What doctor?
Your family doctor?
Dr. Barrett.
His first name?
Albert. Why?
Did you ever go and see this doctor after any of these fights with your husband?
No, I don't think so. You think I'm lying, don't you?
Oh, it may just have slipped your memory. Now, I haven't been able to locate the Campbell woman as yet. It appears that she's away at the moment, holidaying somewhere in Queensland. I'm told she'll be back soon. Mrs. Travers, the more I go into this, the less I understand it.
What?
Well, why did you stay with your husband? You're an intelligent woman. You have a profession. You're quite capable of supporting yourself. Why did you go on putting up with it?
We were married, Mr. Wilson.
How about Karen getting another visit from that lawyer?
Yeah, waste of her time and her money.
You reckon she'll appeal?
Well, I can't see how. She's as guilty as I am.
Guilty as hell.
Thank you, Judge Ferguson.
Oh, look, B, it's Eddie. He's here.
Oh. Come on, Monty. A deal's a deal.
Visitor for you, Mason.
Eddie, this is Monica. Monica, this is Eddie.
G'day.
I said a visitor for Mason. One visitor per prisoner, no more.
Ah, come off it. There's no such regulation, and you know it.
You heard me, Smith.
One visitor per prisoner. Right. Come on, you.
Hey.
Hey, what's going on?
There you are. One visitor, one prisoner. Right.
Me?
Look, you're going to be out of here soon. At the moment, it's more important that Eddie and Monty get to know each other. You want that shop, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what's this all about anyway?
Come over here and sit down.
Okay, what the hell's going on?
B thinks a lot of you.
Yeah, and I think a lot of B. What's it got to do with you?
Oh! Oh! Oh!
This place is going crazy.
Yeah, no more than usual. Tell us about yourself, Eddie.
What?
You're an electrician, weren't you?
I still am. Why?
Marilyn says you haven't got a job.
Yeah, well, I'm not the only one. But I'll be back on my feet soon. Don't you worry about that.
That's good. I like a bloke who can bounce back after a hard knock.
Look, I don't give a stuff what you like. I want to know what I'm doing sitting here with you instead of Marilyn.
Because it might be worth your while, that's why.
Ah, well, that explains everything, doesn't it?
Well, you've got guts, I'll give you that. I've crippled a couple of blokes who've been a lot less polite than you, Sonny Jim.
Great.
Would you like to run my milk bar?
Come again?
I had a shop right on the beach. How would you and Marilyn like to look after it for a while I'm in here?
You're putting me on.
Tease with an agent. All you got to do is make sure you put away 10% of the profits each week for me. That's the only catch. Otherwise, it won't cost you a cent. There's even a couple of rooms out the back and a garden. Now that I've met you, I reckon I can trust you.
Oh, do you? And I suppose this is B's idea of a joke, is it?
It's my idea of a good offer.
Oh, you must think I came down in the last bloody shower.
Do you want it or not?
Look, I came out here to see Marilyn, and you've wasted my time with some cock and bull story. I suppose you think it's a big joke. I suppose you think it's funny.
If it is, the joke's on me, Squirt.
Oh, what's happening, B? Something's going wrong.
Your daughter is bloody stupid, Dr. Sampson. Oh, forget it. He's a bloody idiot. There's no way I'm turning my shop over to that bloody idiot.
Oh,
he's a fool.
No.
And as for you, madam...
Page 43, Doc. I should have been dead 10 years ago. Talk about giving a girl a fright.
Lizzie, this is all about prostate cancer.
Oh, well, perhaps it's page 53. Anyway, that's what it says. I've got cancer. I've got all the symptoms. That's what I've got, symptoms.
What symptoms?
A lump.
All right, strip off and I'll take a look at you.
Take my clothes off.
Well, I can't examine you for breast cancer through your clothes.
Oh, who said it was anything to do with that sort of cancer? Look, it's me elbow. Have a look at the lump.
Lizzie, come in.
Oh, I'm sorry, Doctor. Shall I come back later?
It's quite all right. Miss Birdsworth was just leaving, Lizzie, do us both a favour. Stop reading the book.
Damn doctors. Think they know everything. Wouldn't know the difference between cancer and a gallstone. But I know. And I'll prove it to you.
Another satisfied customer?
What can I do for you?
Oh, I thought that you might just like to know that I've decided to reopen Karen Travers' case.
Yes, I know. She told me.
She's an interesting woman.
Yes, she is.
She's still a little unsure about what she's doing. It's not easy for her. But we're getting there.
Good.
How can you be so stupid?
Look, how was I to know that what she was offering was a real thing?
We had a chance to be set up for life and you blew it.
Yeah, well, why didn't you let me in on it, eh? I mean, haven't I got a say in what happens to us?
Oh, it all happened so fast. Anyway, I thought you'd be pleased. You haven't got a job or anything.
Look, I'm not taking charity from anyone. I'm not having that woman standing over me cracking the whip. I mean, who does she think she is?
She was trying to help us out.
I'm not taking that kind of help from anyone. I am a qualified electrician, not a bloody shopkeeper.
With that racket.
Well, it's not bothering anyone else.
Bothering me.
Stiff, you've caused enough trouble for one day.
What's that supposed to mean, Dad?
Leave her alone. It's not her fault.
You're too damn right it's not my fault.
Like bloody hell, you didn't want to talk to him and you did your best to get his back up.
Bulldust! I made him a bloody good offer. It's not my fault if he's a moron.
He is not a moron.
Oh, he wouldn't know a bee from a bull's foot.
Oh, listen to the great judge of character.
Oh, would you please be quiet? I'm trying to watch this program.
Yeah, shut up. All you do is fight, fight, fight all the time.
You playing cards, Ferguson?
Kid!
Any trouble in here? Travers, turn that television set down. I can hardly hear myself think. Well, we're still fighting over Mason's electrician, are we?
No one's fighting, Miss Bennett.
Don't lie to me. Half the prison can hear you. Birdsworth, didn't I confiscate that book and return it to Dr. Miller?
It's not Dr. Miller's. It comes from the library and Mrs. Jackson got it back for me.
Touché, Miss Bennett.
You think so, Travers? You and Mason get yourselves outside. I've got a few extra duties for you two. We might be able to get a bit of peace and quiet with you two out of the way for a while. No cries of innocence this time, eh, Warner? Get back to your work. I'm not even halfway there yet.
If it hadn't been for Vera outside this morning, we could have had a proper talk to Eddie.
Yeah, it's all her fault.
I sure told her off about me book, didn't I, Bea?
Yeah, and what did she do? Take it out on Karen and Marilyn.
Yeah, well, I've had nothing but trouble from her ever since I came in here.
Yeah, well, this time she's gone too far.
What you gonna do, Bea?
I'll think of something. We'll fix Vinegar Tits' wagon butt good. Oh, anything we can do for you, Mrs. Jackson?
Everything all right in here?
Yeah, fine. Where have you been?
The governor.
Oh, you're among friends now, love. Listen, why not start off on the right foot and give us a hand with something?
No, I don't think so.
We're gonna fix old Vinegar Tits.
No, I couldn't. Look, please, just leave me alone.
You won't be walking out of the place this time, love. If we don't fix her, you're gonna have to live with her too.
Can I have a word with you, Vera?
What is it?
What's going on? The women are up to something. I can feel it. They're certainly not happy.
Oh, it's because I had to discipline those two. That's why.
What for?
They were making trouble with the other women. Almost started a brawl.
Mason and Travers?
Yes, Mason's boyfriend was in earlier and there's been nothing but trouble ever since.
Why?
How should I know? Who understands these animals? I just try and control them. The other day I caught Travers trying to seduce Dr. Miller and Davidson refused to take any action.
You reported it?
Of course I reported it. What was I supposed to do? I mean, you know what we're up against in here.
Yes, I think I do.
If I was governor of this place, Anderson and Doyle would still be here for one thing.
Would they?
Yes, they'd never have got near that fence. Security would have been too tight.
You won't be happy until they bring back the rack and the thumbscrews, will you, Vera?
what?
Have you forgotten who you're supposed to be?
Bad chance with you carrying on like something out of The Sound of Bloody Music.
Yeah, well, you're going to blow the whole thing if you're not careful.
Suits me. This is as bad as being back inside. Must be crazy. We should have bashed the old duck straight off and shot through.
If you want to go, then go. But I'm staying here. I like it, and I like her.
If I say we're going together. Remember, I give the orders round here.
But this is better than being on the run all the time. We're safe here, aren't we? No one would ever think of looking for us here.
Might as well be buried alive.
Oh, come on, Frankie. It's only for a couple of weeks. It can't hurt. And I don't reckon we could have found a better place.
That's your story. Old McBride gives me the creeps.
Can I get you anything, sisters? So nice to have you here. So kind.
Yeah, she's only being nice.
I don't trust her. She's always sneaking up on people. She's not as dumb as she makes out. And how long we got to stay in these things? Driving me mad. I feel like a bloody clothes bus.
Yeah, well, it was your idea, remember?
Sisters.
Oh, sisters, you'll really have to come out and have a look at the garden. The passion fruit's gone mad. I'll have to give some to the neighbours.
Yeah, well, maybe later. We're not really the outdoor type.
Oh. Well, 6 o'clock. I think it's time for a sherry. I don't suppose I could tempt you to join me, just the one?
Well, wasn't really allowed at the convent, but seeing it's a type of wine, I don't suppose the good Lord would take offence to you, sister?
Not if we had just the one.
Good. I was sure it would be all right.
Oh! Oh, what is it, Moni?
I don't know.
Well, where does it hurt?
I think it's my appendix.
Oh. Get up, Ferguson!
She's sick. She needs a doctor.
What's wrong with her?
You go and have your shower, love. I'll look after her.
I think it's my appendix.
If it was, the pain would be on the other side. It always starts on the left side. Now get up, Ferguson. You're not fooling anyone.
I'm sick, Miss Bennett.
I gave you an order. Get out of bed!
What's going on?
Time you had a taste of your own medicine, Vera.
Don't try anything. Smith, Ferguson, if either of you do a thing, you'll wish you hadn't been born.
I'm in here for life. Remember? I've got nothing to lose.
Monica thinks she's got appendicitis. She's lying in bed in agony and can't get up, and Vera won't get help.
Mrs. Jackson, come quick. Vera's gone crazy and she's bashing on her. We can't stop her. Quit! Come on!
No, I'm sick.
Sorry, Molly.
Did she hit her, Mrs. Jackson? I tried to stop her, but she just went crazy and laid her out. She's gone mad, I tell you. Crazy.
Fear!
Look, I told her I was crook and I need to see a doctor. She calls me a liar and tells me to get up. Well, I couldn't at the time because I was in such pain. So she just flies off at me, gives me a backhander. Just did it out of spite, I reckon. And I got witnesses. You asked B. Smith or Lizzie Birdsworth.
Dr. Miller says there's nothing the matter with you. How do you explain the pain?
I thought it was my appendix. Could have been bad wind. Or bad indigestion. The food around here would see to that. But something ought to be done about that basher before she kills someone. She's off her brain.
That'll do, Ferguson. Wait outside.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Have you ever seen Vera strike a prisoner?
No.
Do you think she's harsh with them?
At times. But you know her views on discipline.
Yes. Just the same, I think they've set her up.
Probably. Proving it will be another matter, though.
Oh, you've had the dick rat trap features.
Yeah, I reckon you can kiss that pension of yours goodbye, Vera. So if anyone's going to take your word against mine, as soon as this gets sorted out, well, your lives won't be worth living.
Oh, did you hear that, Mrs. Jackson? More threats of violence.
Yeah. Shut up, Lizzie. Mrs. Davidson wants to see you. You can report to the laundry, Ferguson. You think you're going to get away with this?
Away with what, Mrs. Jackson?
This sort of stunt isn't going to help anyone. Least of all you.
Oh, we're telling the truth. Everyone knows what she's like. It's a wonder she hasn't bashed someone before this. Now, is there anything in your book about sprained wrists?
You
You're not taking this accusation seriously.
Vera, you know that I have to.
With my record of service, do you really think I'd jeopardize that by lashing out at one of those women?
It doesn't matter what I think. I can't just ignore it. The women have rights too, you know.
Oh, yes. The women have rights. The right to do what they damn well please and the right to get away with it. If I was in charge here, I'd show them who had the whip hand.
I'm well aware of your views, Miss Bennet. However, no officer is permitted to lay a hand on a prisoner unless in self-defense. Did you strike Ferguson in self-defense?
Will you tell her? Did you see me strike them?
No, but you were standing over her.
I was standing, thank you very much, Mrs. Jackson.
Yes, well, I think perhaps a couple of days off till we get to the bottom of this.
But that's an admission of guilt.
If you remain on duty, it will only make matters worse. It'll be doubly difficult to get at the truth.
I've told you the truth. I refuse.
I am not asking you, Miss Bennet. I am ordering you.
Well, I can't say I'm surprised. Vera's always looking for trouble.
Monica says they'll have to kick her out.
Yes, but what they have to do and what they do are sometimes two different things. Oh, there's my granddaughter. Excuse me, Lynn.
Hello.
Hello,
Mum.
Hello.
Hello, Lynn. Hi. How did you know my name the other day?
Oh, Meg Jackson told me. Look, if there's any time that you feel like talking with someone.
Talk? What about?
Anything that's bothering you. Sometimes it helps.
Do you think so?
Have you got a lawyer?
No, does it matter? Well, I'll be here tomorrow to meet you and they'll let you out.
Oh, you make me sound like a wild animal.
Oh, Grandma, you know what I mean. So exciting.
Yes, but, well, I've got my share of butterflies, too.
Why?
Well, it's almost like starting a new family all over again.
Oh, Grandma, we'll do all right. I know we will.
Tell me about our flat.
Oh, I've told you already.
Well, tell me again.
My first ever visitor. The kid with foot and mouth disease. Knew it was too good to be true.
Cut it out, B. Look, I'm here to say I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, you should be saying that to Marilyn. I don't have to put up with you.
I didn't do too good, did I?
Oh, you might say that.
Well, look, I've been thinking.
Hmm.
And now that I know what's her name, Monica's telling the truth, well, Marilyn really wants that shop and mightn't be such a bad idea if Monica would give us another chance.
Your middle name is Mud.
Well, I said I was sorry. Well, couldn't you just talk to her and tell her how bad I feel?
Have you ever tried talking to a runaway truck?
Look, I know I'm asking a lot, but if anyone can talk around, you can. Well, I'd really appreciate it. Not just for my sake, either.
Oh, all right. And not just for your sake.
Thanks, B.
We both need our heads read.
You must be out of your bloody minds.
Oh, please, Monty.
I already said no.
Now, come on, Monty. Let bygones be bygones.
I'm not forgetting what he said.
He's already apologised. What do you want him to do? Kiss your feet?
Well, it wouldn't do you much good if he did, because I've already made up my mind.
Go on, Monty. Give us another chance. Well, he didn't mean to be like that. It was just a shock to him, that's all.
Yeah, well, it was a shock to me too, I can tell you. Came close to necking him, the little runt.
Let him have the shock.
No. It can stay empty for all I care.
Then what about your 10%? You going to let that go down the drain? You're cutting off your nose to spite your face.
Who needs it?
All right. If you don't let him have the shop, I'm going to tell the governor you set Vera up.
What?
Shut up.
You wouldn't dare.
Wouldn't I? I'll tell her it was all your idea.
Yeah, well, you'd be up to your neck in it too.
If I dob you in, I get off light. It's your neck.
All right, you can have the shop. It's got nothing to do with that. I just happen to think you're okay, and I'm willing to forget the past. Well, if he's worth going to all this trouble, I reckon he must be worth something.
Thanks, Monty.
Yeah, well, you just remember that 10% or I'll break your backs.
Vera. Vera, it's only a temporary measure, I'm sure. Just for a day or two until we find out.
Well, according to you, Mrs. Jackson, I was standing over Ferguson. It seems to me you've already made up your mind.
Just stated the facts. It's hard to know what to believe.
Well, why can't you believe me?
We've been working here together for years. You take their side. You know how much this job means to me.
I have been here before, you know, to see one of the prisoners. Karen Travers. I'm her lawyer, Stephen Wilson.
Excuse me, Mr. Wilson?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I couldn't help it overhearing. I'm Jean Vernon, the regional services officer.
Hmm?
Welfare.
Well, how do you do?
I heard you say you were going to see one of the prisoners.
Yes, that's right, and I'm quite late. If you'll excuse me.
Oh, I won't keep you a minute. I just want to tell you about a girl here called Lynn Warner. She's on remand at the moment and could do with some legal advice.
Miss Vernon, look, I'm very busy.
If she had a good lawyer, she could get off with a pretty light sentence. She's had a couple of bad breaks, that's all.
Well, I'm sure the courts will look after her. Excuse me.
The girl needs some help, Mr. Wilson. 5 minutes of your time.
Miss Vernon, doesn't your organization have its own lawyers to look after these cases?
Certainly. But you could ease the girl's mind today. I thought you were in the helping profession. Or is it just property conveyancing and legalizing tax evasions as far as you're concerned?
You have a very unusual manner, Miss Vernon. I hope that you'll have more success with the women in this prison than you're likely to have with me.
Are you going now, Mum?
Soon, dear. I wonder who'll take care of these. But it won't be like the last time. I missed it all, even this cell. So much. You have no idea how much.
Oh, Mum.
Oh, now, dear. You'll be all right.
Oh, I want you to be happy. I want so much for you to be happy.
You're still young. You've got plenty of time to start over again. If I can be given another chance at my age, there's nothing you can't do when they let you out of here. It's taken me 15 years, Lynn. But maybe this time I'll do better.
Jean?
Yeah.
There's a gentleman here to see you.
Thank you.
Mr. Wilson.
I've just been to see Karen Travers. I was about to return to my office when the thought struck me that we parted on rather less than friendly terms this morning.
Could have been worse. You could have charged me for your time.
There you go again.
If you've come to apologize...
I came because I felt that I owed to myself to make my position perfectly clear.
I thought it was clear enough.
I'd appreciate it if you'd hear me out.
I'm listening.
I'm a professional, Miss Vernon, the same as you. Now, that means that I get paid for my services, the same as you. I don't feel that I have to ease my conscience by rushing about defending or counseling those people who can't afford my services. That is what legal aid is for. I earn my living the same as anyone else. You pay, and I'll deliver. I might also add that I sleep extremely well.
Simple as that.
If you can arrange for it, I'll see the girl for 5 minutes.
After that fine speech of making yourself perfectly clear.
Just this once.
Maybe you have got a conscience that needs easing.
5 minutes?
A very small conscience.
Ah, finished packing?
Yes, almost. It's amazing how little I've accumulated over the years. Our little flat is going to seem quite bare.
Oh, you'll soon fill it up, especially when the baby arrives.
Probably. Hope I can remember how to look after a baby.
Oh, that's something you never forget. Besides, there are lots of clinics and nurses to help you out these days.
And perhaps you'll drop round from time to time.
Perhaps.
Oh, I know it's against prison regulations for you to have anything to do with ex-prisoners, but surely the occasional cup of tea can't do any harm.
I'm sure it can't. Besides, if you won't tell anybody, I promise I won't.
Oh, it seems strange to be packing up again. Last time I left here, I thought I'd never come back. But now it's hard to be so sure of anything.
Hey, you'd better be sure. A lot of people have stuck their necks out for you. You just try and put this place behind you.
That's funny. That's exactly what Bill said to me last time.
Well, you should have listened to him.
Yes, I should. Must be hard for you, working here without him.
Working here isn't easy for anyone, Mum. Now, if you're ready, Mrs. Davidson would like to see you in the office.
Right.
If you ever come back in here again, I'll beat the hell out of you.
No way. Not with the shop.
It'll be bloody hard work, you know.
I don't know how we're going to repay you, Monty.
Don't you worry about that, darling. You just remember that 10%. 1 cent of that money goes walkabout.
Yeah, we know. Wish you good luck, why don't you?
Marilyn, are you ready?
Okay, Mrs. Jackson.
What are the rest of you doing in here?
Tell her to come back soon.
Well, hurry up and then get back to work.
Lizzie.
I'll be seeing you, love.
Don't believe everything you read in books now. Thanks, Moni.
You'll do all right, kid.
Hey, Marilyn.
Yeah?
Eddie doesn't snore, does he?
No. He sleeps like a baby.
Thank goodness for
you'll
that.
Get yours, madam.
The best I can wish you is to hope we never see you again. But that's up to you. You both have a chance this time to make new lives for yourselves and others. Most of the women who leave here don't have that opportunity, so there shall be no reason for any backsliding. I hope everything goes well for both of you.
Thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
Before you go, there is one other thing. Have either of you heard any talk about the allegation against Miss Bennet?
No.
Marilyn?
I don't know anything, Mrs. Jackson.
Well, you've been sharing with Smith and Ferguson. You must have heard something.
You realize Miss Bennet could lose her job because of this? If it is a lie, don't you think it's pretty despicable to destroy someone's career just like that? Very well. You may go.
Jesus, Doreen. You sneak up on me like that again and I'll bend the shovel over your flaming head. Get back inside and keep your eye on that old lady.
I came out here to tell you I've decided something.
I do the deciding round here, now scram.
I've decided that we're going to tell Miss McBride who we really are.
You going right round the bend? Why don't you pop over and tell the neighbours as well?
I can't go on lying to her anymore, and you're going to blow the whole thing in the way you're carrying on. And you said yourself she isn't stupid.
You must be bloody stupid if you think you can get away with that. She'd report us to the cops in 5 minutes flat. Anyway, you were the one that wanted to stay here. You got to live with it. I don't want to lay the old bag out, but I'm going to have to if you spill the beans. All right.
I've got to tell you this, Miss McBride, but you've got to promise not to do anything first because we don't want to hurt you.
There's no need to say any more, dear. I don't want to hear it. I've always known exactly who you were, Frankie. The moment you both walked through the front door, I knew. I may live alone, but I know what's going on outside. Look, I don't care what you've done. It's been wonderful having you here, and as far as I'm concerned, you can both stay as long as you like. It's up to you. There is one condition, though.
What?
Do take that iron bar out of your sleeve, Frankie. Must be so uncomfortable.
Mr. Wilson, this is Lynn Warner. Lynn, the gentleman behind my desk is Mr. Wilson.
Hello, Lynn.
Take a seat.
Well, Lynn, Miss Vernon has told me briefly about your circumstances. But you realize, of course, that the court may take into consideration the fact that you were wrongly imprisoned for some time prior to these present charges. But then again, they may not. After all, you were definitely an accessory to an armed robbery, and that is a very serious crime. How did you get involved in this?
I did it for my husband.
Did he intimidate you or bully you into doing it?
No, he loved me.
Yes, well, that's not going to be very much help, I'm afraid. If he'd forced you with threats or violence, but as it stands, if you admit that you were a willing accomplice to an armed robbery which led to two deaths...
One of those was Lynn's husband.
The prosecution will hardly soft-pedal because of that. I was merely making the point that two men died.
The point has been taken, Mr. Wilson.
Well, if you want my advice, quite honestly, it doesn't look good.
Are you going to take on my case?
No. No, legal aid and the courts will look after you, I'm sure. They've got some good people. Miss Vernon simply wanted me to give you some advice.
And I think you've given quite enough, Mr. Wilson.
What?
Thank you. Goodbye.
All right. Goodbye.
Lynn, I'm sorry if I upset you. Look, I have to go and see Mum and her granddaughter to their new home. But we'll talk again soon, okay?
To pick up the keys about now. Huh? Marilyn and Eddie, they'll be moving into the shop.
Oh, I must have been out of my mind letting you talk me into giving them the place. Imagine my shop being run by a pro.
Ex-pro.
Yeah. Well, I wonder how long it'll take her before she's giving massages in the back room.
Oh, shut up and play. Marilyn's a leader, listen. They'll turn that place into a little gold mine. You wait and see. And all you'll have to do is sit back and rake in the profits.
Fat lot of good it's going to do me in here. I mean, what am I going to spend it on?
Well, you could always hire yourself an expensive lawyer. Of course, he'd have to be good-looking, eh, Karen?
Hmm?
I said she could hire herself an expensive, good-looking lawyer.
Hmm.
You know, she's just about as good company as you are.
Karen, I want you to collect your things from your cell. You're moving in with Smith and Ferguson.
Why?
Governor's orders. Oh, there's some new prisoners arriving today. I'm sure you remember how keen you were to have a single cell when you first arrived.
Don't worry, love. You'll be nice and cosy in with us. Sleep like a baby.
Yeah, if you can stand the snoring.